to suggest the slider onto the computer is barely visible. Oh, remember last time they said, oh, I'm gonna add some more menus the next time you open the game? That's it. Please adjust the slider onto the dog and cat are friends. Alright. Until the number 5 becomes 9. 9, there we go. That's wild. Please adjust the slider until you stop adjusting the... Posture. Which of the two made-up words below is the most appealing to you? Boinkle. Scrumptush. That's easier. I'm gonna go with that. Please don't adjust the slider. Don't tell me what to do. Do you know what time it is right now? Yes, I know. Is it time that it is right now? The correct time? Yes. What is time anyway? Yes. I don't answer questions. Posture check. We did posture check before. Is there anything about yourself you haven't told me? Yes. You don't know anything. Help. No, I'm not gonna help you. Will you come back to visit me? Oh, I actually feel bad. You know what? Yes, I will. Even if I don't stream, I will. I will, man. Don't you worry. Is this what AI feels like, chat? Like every time you turn the PC off, they die, basically? I will visit you, man. Begin the game.
This is the story.
Alright, we're gonna skip right there. So we're gonna try to get the alternate endings this time.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
New content. Wait a second. New content. Yo. Should we go over here or should we try to get the...
When you know Stanley what? No, I'm not going to do that just yet. Two open doors,
I'm going to try and do the other left. One. We're going to do new content in a bit, but there was another path that I didn't
yet,
do last
time. There
was
not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief,
with no expectation
Stanley
of promotion
to
or
go
recognition,
up to his boss's office, of
not
hoping
fired.
He might find an answer there. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Okay, here we go.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held?
Apparently, some people hear voices.
What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845.
Extra secret PIN number.
But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by
sheer luck. No, I think Schizo is something else. Amazing. Like, you see things that are
he
not there.
He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Selena lays on the couch, watching this stream. My narrator, probably. Alright, here we go. You see and hear things. I guess it could be mild level if you're not seeing things.
Descending deeper
things,
into the building, Stanley realized
there.
He felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job.
Right.
Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long.
Whoa.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna escape. So last time we went there, we tried both options, we got both endings. This way, we're escaping.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Would meet his violent death? Okay, it's fine. It's fine.
The
You're
door behind
lying.
Him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
Tempting, but no. Once I set my mind into something,
At
I'll
this
definitely
point,
do it.
Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Willingly confront his death. All right, here we go. You guys ready? Be brave, Chad. Be brave. This is not the end. This is just the beginning. Oh, I'm not dead. Whoa. I'm actually not.
As the machine whirred into motion and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his
demise,
he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever.
Oh, nah.
Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real
story. I'm about
story,
to get squashed.
Trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this world is.
No, no, please.
Perhaps his
please.
Death was of no
great I'll be
loss,
good boy.
Like plucking
I'll
the
be a good boy, please.
So
don't spank me, please. I'll be a good boy.
To his brief and shallow
no,
life.
No, please. Not like that. No. Oh well. Oh.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal
lady?
Jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
Wait, I'm dead? But... Wait, somebody else took over. No sus face? What do you mean? I didn't do sus... Oh, the Stanley Parable.
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game, back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
That's true. I'm gonna keep going forward. There we go, that's where we gotta go. This game is absolutely crazy. My narrative probably.
When every
Whoa.
Path you can walk has been created
Whoa.
For you long in advance,
uh-huh.
death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
Stanley's computer. That's crazy. What is... You know what this reminds me of, chat? Heaven in Supernatural TV show. You guys seen it? Corridor. The pacing of this opening section was important to get right. The corridor has been moved and altered to make sure the player reaches two doors at a good time. Oh, this is the map of the... Oh, of the office. Office layout. The blueprint shows the office from the beginning of the game. The path from Stanley's office to the door... was the first part of the game that was built. Oh, so this is like the designer's layout, basically. That's pretty interesting. Filing cabinets. And then we got the two doors. Button sounds. A selection of sounds used. Throughout the game, when buttons are pressed, each sound is a mix of keyboards, stroke, and a synthesized tone. Oh, each one sounds different. That was the worst one so far. And we got some PC, office computers. Turn them off. There we go. Save electricity. Based on the work. Oh, these are like the people that actually worked. Credits. The office. The maintenance room. You know what? This is actually a very cool touch. Wow. The lounge. This is so trippy. the apartment timer, right? The previous version of choice leading to the apartment ending, a timer would give you 15 seconds to pick up the phone. Not picking up the phone would lead to a different ending. Oh. The cargo lift. So this is basically showing you all the alternate paths that you could take and what could have happened. The meeting room. That's actually pretty wild, huh? You're getting spoilers. Oh well. Wait, what? Countdown desk. Monitor room elevator. Freedom ending. We got this already, right? We got this. The countdown room. We had the explosion ending as well. So we could get out of there. Or what's back here? The game design. Alright, let's get out of here. We're done. We're gonna go ahead and... Oh. Oh, what's down there? Freedom ending. What is that? Boss's office. The lounge, underground. Narrator outtakes. Key Van Brighting, the voice of the narrator, recorded dialogue for the entire game roughly nothing three there. Separate times over the
shoot.
2 years.
Try the other one then.
Oh, for 2 years. God damn. Okay. Alright, Chad, we're done. This is actually a very cool touch that they decided to add in the game. Office clock. Alright, let's get out of here. Let's go. Can I press the button? Can I press the button? Let me press it. Alright, here we go.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another.
Uh-huh.
How they both wish to be free. Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another?
Uh-huh.
No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen.
But I see it. I see it. Ooh.
Listen to me. You can still save those two. You
okay.
can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path.
What is happening?
Stop now and it'll be your only true choice.
Resume.
Whatever you do, choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let
Oh, got squashed. Oh well. You know what, chat? It's okay. I became a sandwich, but it's fine. And here we are! As I said, death is not the ending, it's just the beginning.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could
Right, now we're gonna do the extra content,
Stanley decided
remember?
To go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
New content.
Oh! Ooh. New content?
Uh-huh.
What does that mean? New
I don't
content.
Know. Let's see what we got. New content. Oh. Yo! Okay, this is pretty cool. Where are we going? Where are we going? It's a huge factory, huh? Oh, hell yeah. Let's go.
Hello, and thank you for playing the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe. As you may know, the Stanley Parable was a video game released in 2013 on home computers.
I did not know that.
After receiving critical and commercial success, it was expanded upon in 2022 with the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, a reimagining of the game for consoles and
not just any deluxe, Chad. Ultra Deluxe, okay?
The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe features exciting new content that broadens and expands the world of the Stanley Parable, delighting audiences the world over. Please, step inside and see what thrilling new adventures await in The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe.
Oh, well, this sounds delightful. I'm very excited to see the thrilling new Ultra Deluxe content.
Ultra Deluxe. Yeah, I'm sure the experience would be Ultra Deluxe as well. You know what, Chad? That was actually really cool.
Okay, so far it's an elevator.
I feel like I'm watching a TV show.
I'm sure it's just the beginning of a mesmerizing adventure.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Let's go, I'm ready. Wait, what?
Is it broken? What's going on here? Should we be moving somewhere or... Oh, there we go.
There we go.
All right, finally, at long last, it's on to the new content. I've never been more ready. Let's do it.
All right. You guys excited?
Mm.
Let's go.
Mm.
Some ultra deluxe content.
I have
content.
To say, initial impressions of Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, mostly tedious. It's as if them... Oh, okay. Let's see the content. Give me the content, Stanley.
Oh, what is this?
All right, let's see. It's the jump circle.
Huh. That's what we gotta do. Okay. No way. Sweet potato. Thanks for the follow over on Twitch. Appreciate it. All right, here we go. Keep jumping around. This is extra content, chat. Mm-hmm. Come on. 20 more times. Come on, Stanley. I mean, not Stanley. You can do this. 2, 1, 0. Woo! Wait, what? We're done. Okay. Stanley, you're not gonna say anything?
Is that it? Surely that's not all the new content. There has to be something else, right?
Again, elevator.
Goodness. Another elevator. Stanley, I have to say, initial impressions of this game are not positive. It's just elevators and jumping.
Uh-huh.
Is this what passes for exciting new content? If this is new content, then I could just read you the whole dictionary. There's 20
That's
hours
great.
Of new content right there. Hell, I could count to 30 trillion. You could put that on the box. The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, now with over 1,000 hours of new content. And if... Oh, wait. There's more. Very good. Yes. I knew there had to be something.
He's
else.
Saying things
Let's
out loud
it.
That
I'm ready for
we have all been thinking.
Is.
Oh, ultra deluxe content. Here we come. And we came. Thank you for enjoying the
That's it? Oh, you've got to be kidding me. You see, Stanley? This is what happens when greedy video game developers with no respect for their fan base rush a cheap expansion to market for no reason other than to make an easy dollar. And don't get me started on the level of craftsmanship that's gone into it. In fact, I'm looking right now at the game's achievements, and it's hard to believe one of them actually says, "Test achievement, please ignore." What quality assurance department signed off on this? I'm infuriated and I'm offended, and I intend to find these people on Twitter and hold them personally accountable. It's my fault, Stanley.
My God.
I built up too much anticipation around the new content, I'm afraid. It could never have lived up to such expectations. If you're still with me, why don't we just reset the game and we'll try to get back to what the Stanley Parable is really about.
Uh-huh.
No frills, no gimmicks. Just you and me having a great time together like always. What do you say, friend?
Wait, Ashley, when you tried to type anything on Twitch, did it say anything or you just couldn't? Oh, here we are. Okay. Oh, the office looks different. What? No
Psst.
Way.
Stanley,
yes.
Come over here in the vent. I want to show you something.
What if I don't want to? Okay, you know what? Let's go. Let's go check it out. Let's go. All right, here we go. Going to the vents. Oh. It's his coffee nut. And more vents.
Okay, you remember how cheap and unsatisfying the new Ultra Deluxe content turned out to be? Well, it
yes.
got me thinking about the past and how much better the Stanley Parable used to be.
Uh-huh.
So I made something special and tucked it away here where the game's developers won't find it.
Oh wow.
Just
oh my god.
Secret.
Tomb Raider. Oh. Yo, no
I
shot.
I call it the Memory Zone. It's where I've been storing all my favorite memories so
oh,
I can relive the peak experiences of my life whenever I want.
Wow.
Experiences like the launch of the Stanley Parable on PC.
I've seen sometimes I've have issues with Twitch when I'm using VPN. So I don't know if you are using VPN, Ashley, but that could be it if you were. The memory zone. Chat, this looks incredible. Look at this. Oh, what I wouldn't give to go to a place like this. Just to visit. Here we are.
You see, Stanley, doesn't the memory zone remind you of how wonderful Stanley Parable was before it was sullied with a cheap re-release? Remember back in October of 2013, when the game originally launched?
Uh-huh.
Back then, video games had integrity.
Oh.
Back then, it all meant something. Oh, the waste.
Oh, it's crazy how they'll, like, buy on Steam. Oh, this is the original one, huh? The original remake. In loving memory. The Stanley Parable, the original. A trip down the memory lane. Alright, you guys ready? Demonstration. Go outside. Don't play for 5 years. Unachievable. It's impossible to get this achievement. Nominee. British Academy Award. Nominee. A new video game releasing today. New York Times. October 17, 2013. There's no way it was in the front page back then, right? I don't know. That's crazy. Akira, welcome back. Los Angeles Times. Stanley Parable Duel's Tough Choices. Oh, wow. This is actually very peaceful, huh?
Je suis dans la mémorisation. C'est sur la pluie des loups. Et je n'attends plus que toi, mon amour.
And over here is where I keep reviews of the Stanley Parable. Like this stunning triumph of games journalism. 10 out of 10 from Destructoid.com. James Stephanie Sterling writes, and I quote, "Where so many games that aspire to be more than games end up less than any form of art, Stanley Parable strives and then succeeds to be every game ever created." Did you hear that, Stanley? Every game ever created.
Uh-huh.
That's how grand and all-encompassing the original Stanley Parable was. It was literally every game ever created. It was Skyrim, it was Persona
Sounds
3,
like
it was all
language.
Of them. And now, it's nothing. It's
Don't
no
say
games
that, man.
At all.
Don't say
it
that.
It isn't even the Stanley Parable anymore. It's just a husk now. A lifeless husk with an hour of new elevator content.
Hour of new elevator content. Alright, here we go. Ooh. What's down here? Maintenance, okay. We're going this way. The original. Person of the year. Ooh.
Here's another moving passage, this time from GameSpot.com. The Stanley Parable is both a richly stimulating commentary on the nature of choice in games and one that offers some of
what
the most enjoyable, surprising,
really
and rewarding choices I've ever been confronted with in a game. 9 out of 10. Don't you get it, Stanley? The
I
game
couldn't explain
was
it
perfect.
Even if I wanted to.
It didn't need anything else. It didn't need new content. It just needed to be left alone. To spend the rest of time collecting dust in the hallowed hall of beloved video game memories.
Game about choices? I guess you could say that, yeah. But it's like, if we just say that, it's not even like 10% of what this game offers.
These were simpler times, Stanley.
Uh-huh.
But I wouldn't give to go back to have it all over again.
Right. Okay, so I guess we gotta go this way then. Maybe the maintenance room is open now. There we go, it's open.
Wait, hang on.
Uh-huh.
I don't recall this part of the memory zone before. What's this? What's down here?
Oh no. This is like post-apocalyptic situation right here.
Oh no.
Smelly, what's
God,
up?
No. Stanley, it's a collection of reviews from Steam, the online video game distributor.
I haven't looked at these in years. Mm-hmm. I can't even imagine what's been collecting down here.
Steam reviews.
Surely these reviews were glowing as well, weren't they?
Uh-huh. Yeah, don't worry, Akira. Appreciate it. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and check. Ooh.
Honestly, I could not be bothered to play this game to full completion. The narrator is obnoxious and unfunny.
Unfunny?
His humor and dialogue proving to be more irritating than entertaining. Unfunny! I'm not trying to be funny. I'm trying to make a serious work of art. I suppose I could write up a handful of gags to insert into the Stanley parable, but the game is already such a densely layered web of profound philosophical insights that I can't even imagine where I'd have the room to stick them.
The person that wrote the review is like, yeah, he doesn't understand anything, or they don't understand anything. All right, here we go. Yeah, keeps breaking the fourth wall again and again and again. All right, so we can hop over here. Oh, we gotta go that way. Okay. All right, Stanley, let's go, man. We're a team. Do we go over? Yeah, we gotta go in there. Okay, what's back here? Nothing. Steam reviews. How did you get the Open Mind achievement? There's gonna be a doppelganger that has a swirly face, and he comes in and says 42. That's it. It's a doppelganger. It's a doppelganger.
Okay, let's see what this one says. While the idea for the game is good, for someone who prefers non-linear games, this preachiness gets annoying fast. Preachy? Stanley? I'm not preachy, am I?
Maybe a little
bit. You can tell me if I'm preachy. Honestly, you can. Oh, goodness.
Maybe a little bit.
This is actually quite shocking for me.
Uh-huh.
I had always thought of the game's dialogue as being rather terse to begin with.
These are actual reviews.
I don't know how much fluff I cut from the game to get it to feel as light and airy as it... Well, I always thought it did. But maybe it wasn't. Oh, dear. What an awful memory to have to hold on to. These black marks on my otherwise unimpeachable track record.
Uh-huh.
I feel like a failure.
This guy's name is Nude something. His opinion has no value, okay? Don't worry, pal. Listen. This guy's name is Nude something. He doesn't count. All right, we go. Here we go. The extra deluxe unachievable content. Ooh. Oh,
what's
some
this
more
one got to say? You constantly
they played almost 10 hours
anything so the narrator can catch up with his long-winded explanations of what's happening. I wish there was a skip button. Well, yes, I think we can do that. If I'm truly too preachy, then maybe letting you skip ahead for just a moment, surely it couldn't hurt. Not if it means we can strike these negative reviews from the record. Only positive reviews of the Stanley Parable. That's my motto today, and it's always been my motto. I'd do anything for the customer, Stanley. Yes, a skip button we shall have.
Oh, okay, let's go.
And here it is. Go ahead and give it a shot. I'll pop you forward in time so that the second my incessant droning starts to bore you, with just the push of a button, you'll have zipped right past it. It's what the players have been asking for, and I'm very proud to have delivered. No more listening to me rambling on and on and on. No. The Stanley Parable is a game for the people. And if the people want silence, then by goodness, that's what they're going to get. Well, don't sit around waiting for me to shut up. Go ahead and make me shut up. Here, we'll pretend that I've just begun
stop,
an interminable monologue, and it goes something like this.
Okay, I'm gonna hear it.
The story, and the choices, or what have you, and therefore, by becoming it is, so on and so forth, until inevitably, we all, until the end of time, at which time, everything all at once, so, now you see, blah, 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 blah,
dude,
blah,
stop.
Blah, blah. We've eaten too much, and it can't be just yet, no, until 245. But the logic of elimination working backwards, the deduction therefore becomes impossible to manufacture.
What are you talking
it
about?
It went on for nearly 10,000 years.
I don't want to skip you, Stanley. I mean, here and there, the narrator. And back. But you gotta stop talking, man.
Before lunchtime. It can't be. It's the only thing there is. How many billion?
Oh, hey. You're back, you see? You were only back. Frozen in time for a few minutes, but it was plenty of time for me to deliver a long, rambling monologue full of unnecessary verbal flourishes and lengthy ruminations on the nature of choice in video games. Of course, I happen to believe it was perhaps one of my more profound such stuff? Ruminations. Not that, of course, you need a description of it, but if I had to describe it, I'd say it was perhaps less of a rumination and more of a treatise. Or
I guess I can see why people played this game for 9 hours, because you as well, they're probably stuck there listening to this guy just preach nonstop.
Any choice you've ever made is simply a series of
choices. And remember how they said he took 2 years to do all the recording? Now we know why.
Having made said choice. That is to say, if by articulating a choice you've well, there, sport, you really did catch me rambling on a bit, didn't you?
I did.
But that's the power of the button. The minute I start to go off on a thoughtless display of self-absorption, it's right at your fingertips to go poof, and it's all over. Oh, I can't wait to see what Cookie Nine will say about this, and whether they'll edit the rating of their Steam review, or at least change some of the wording, perhaps.
Maybe they forget the password.
I don't even know if one can change their review in the first place. I guess I should become better educated on exactly how Steam works. Perhaps that would have been the smart thing to check on before I went about this whole exercise of making the skip button. Mm-hmm. Although I have to imagine that after seeing this exciting new technology at work, surely whoever it is runs Steam will instantly run out and implement a new feature to make it possible to edit one's review, merely because of this very situation. Yes, I think that... Okay, welcome back, Stanley. Now, I should say that the amount of time the button has been skipping through is becoming longer and longer.
Oh,
that last
right?
one was, well,
yes.
I want to say maybe 30, 45 minutes?
No way.
It's not unendurable by any means, but it's, well, there's really only so much I can ramble on to myself about. I know, it's shocking, isn't it? But at any rate, I do suggest
can
that
play
we
exit
not
eight?
Press
we already
the button again.
Played and we got all
I
the
think
anomalies,
the skip
too.
The button has been aptly demonstrated, and we can say goodbye to
oh,
it.
Oh, by the way, there's a new wait, Exit 8 game coming out, okay?
Where did the door go?
From a new developer.
Wasn't there a door that led into this room?
I already have the code,
I
but I just can't play it yet.
One here
I'm going to have to wait
how
a few days
would
more
we have
because it hasn't
the
been
room
released.
In the first place. I don't think one can
but
enter
it's very
a room without a door
so
of some sort,
that
or window or something week. Like that. Do you see a window anywhere? A porthole? A sufficiently large crack in the wall? I'll take any of these. All I want.
Shut up, man.
Stanley, please don't push the button again. It's been 12 hours. You've just
shit.
Been frozen there. I don't know why the skips are getting longer, but they're really, truly getting longer. And my God, there's no way out of the room. Stanley, the door is gone. It's completely gone. I've looked at it from every angle. I've checked every one of those walls 1,000 times. And there's no door, Stanley.
So I'm stuck
there's
here.
There's no door. There's
with
just
this,
you
with this guy that
button,
never stops
and
talking.
If you keep pressing it, I have no idea what will happen.
The
I have no
vanished.
Idea how long I'll be made to sit here. And more than anything else, I don't know how to stop you from pressing the button again. I can't control anything in this room, Stanley. I can't touch it.
Why
and
not?
I have to believe. I have to
don't
know
you do,
that sooner
don't you know
or later,
everything?
No matter how much I plead with you, you're going to press the button again. Why would you? I've been thinking and thinking, and I don't know what I can do to convince you otherwise. Oh, my God. And it's all because of those reviews. Those reviews that I couldn't get out of my head. I just couldn't... Oh, Stanley, you're back.
I don't know
you're
how long
back.
It's been.
Oh, my goodness. I have someone to talk to again.
Uh-huh.
Stanley, I think it's been a week.
It's been a week.
Or 2 weeks?
2 weeks.
I've been sitting here all that time. Just sitting here. Not a single person.
He's gonna
to
go
speak.
Crazy.
And you'd think that that's just how it's always been, right? Me talking and you saying nothing. Would you think that it's exactly the same as always?
I'll skip in a
second.
Doesn't
that feel like what we've already been doing? Me just
I'll
talking?
I'll skip again.
But it isn't, Stanley. It isn't the same at all. It isn't even close.
Uh-huh.
Because I know you can't hear me once you push that button.
No,
that's
I can't.
That's what I'm realizing now, Stanley. I'm realizing that I needed to know that someone was listening.
I feel bad for
you. I needed there to be a vessel through which my words were moving. It was the vessel I needed, Stanley. Not the outcomes, not the story.
And there he goes rambling. Oh, no. What happened?
Oh, Hello, it's you. You're here again. Welcome. I have had time to think about you and about us and about everything we've been through. I've had so much time. I stopped keeping track after a year.
After
a
year.
Have you ever sat down in one place and not moved for one entire year? Let me describe it for you. To begin with, there is only regret. There is only the turning wheel of missed opportunities. Okay. I felt nothing at all but regret for the longest time, Stanley. Days.
I am so sorry, months, man.
I lost it all in a blur of the deepest longing to undo the past.
Like, I wonder what would happen if you don't press the skip. Like, how long would he keep talking?
Is what I can only describe as the collapse of every moment I have ever experienced my entire life. All of them collapsed down into a single instant.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna
In that instant, I could see myself clearly, calmly, with a collected heart.
Uh-huh.
It was an impossibly rich wellspring of both delight and disgust simultaneously. I was consumed by it. I could do nothing but wallow in it for what felt like an eternity, for what I now know was far less. You see, it was a revelation for me. It was unlike anything I had ever known. It was a space without consequence.
I think I'm gonna
skip
it again.
Without action or outcome. It was divorced entirely.
Hello. You're not even gonna say hello to me? I'm back, your friend. Your friend is back. Wait, Chet, he's not talking to me anymore. Oh no, I think he's actually mad. What? The clock fell off. Oh my god, stop! Stop it! Make it go away, please!
But they didn't understand the game was never meant to be funny. It was meant to have a point. It was meant to speak to the human condition. But where are the jokes? Where are the jokes? They bemoaned, they screamed, they gnashed their teeth and said, entertain us. It wasn't enough. They had to leave a pathetic little thumbs down review and make
all of their pitiful demands.
But
reviews.
Then, he's talking too much, they said. First, he didn't entertain us, now he won't shut up. It's the inconsistency, it's the lack of accountability, it's the unwillingness to examine with an uncompromising heart the words that they are speaking into the world.
Uh-huh.
As though there were no consequences for a lack of cohesion in one's assessment of others. But of course, absolutely anyone can leave a review.
Actually upset.
So here's what we get. We get these demands that seek everything and are accountable to nothing. We get a world where someone will say, oh, there should be a skip button. You should be able to freeze Stanley in place. While the narrator sits there forever and ever. We want all of this in the new Stanley Parable. We demand it. And then, because it was said, because it was spoken, now it simply has to happen.
Uh-huh.
The most immediate desires, every single thing demanded by every person at every moment in time. If someone wants it, then it's a crime not to bring it into being. Have we been given to indulging every fleeting whim for no reason other than to do so? Yes! Yes, it seems that this is now the world we live in. It seems that we are a people living in such bleakness and discomfort with ourselves that our entertainment is now our lives. It has come to represent us. It absolutely must speak to who we are as people, because otherwise, without our entertainment, we have nothing. Without entertainment, we would have to face inward toward the cruel bleakness inside ourselves. We would turn to look at our deeper nature and find a resounding emptiness gazing back with unyielding aggression.
Okay,
and so,
dude.
So because of this, we require that our amusements
and
our play...
He's getting... Narrator, hello, can you hear me? Dude, are you mad with me? Come on now, don't be mad, listen. Lynn, good night. Oh, you're still awake, that's wild. Have a good night.
The end is never the end, is never the end, is never the
end. Oh, he's lost his
mind. The end is never the end, is never the end.
Dude, I'm here.
The end is never the end, is never the end.
It's probably been like 20, 30 years.
Is never the end.
Yeah, he's done. Die on the toilet. All right, Selena, don't die on the toilet, but have a good night. There's a Final Destination coming out. Ooh. I don't know if I watched the latest one. Oh, nah. What is this? We can actually escape? Oh, this place. Oh, I think he's actually gone now. Whoa. I actually feel bad for the narrator. Yep. Oh wow, cool. I mean, there's no door. Can I get out of here? I ain't going to sleep. I can't even sleep. Maybe try listening to music, because some very calm music sometimes helps you sleep. Maybe try listening to those. That might help. What was that? Who's screaming? Hello? I've been probably living down here for hundreds of years, I think. Oh, the button's broken. Yo, freedom! Is this the freedom I wanted, chat? I feel like I'm the only human being alive in this place, and there's nobody there. The last person alive. This is actually sad. Like, if you have to be the last person to be alive and you can't die, like, you're literally immortal, what's your purpose in life? Like, what are you gonna do? What happens then? Right? Oh, should I go back and see if I can press the button again? Hold on, I'm gonna try to do that. Oh. Never mind. Oh, here we are again. Hello! Wait, chat, he's not talking anymore.
All of his
anymore.
Co-workers were gone.
Okay, there
what
he goes.
What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he
I thought he was actually gone forever. Okay, so what's going to be different this time? New content. New content. You guys ready? Here we go.
Oh, good. You noticed my sign.
Oh, I did.
Yes, I have something very, hard to very exciting to show you.
Uh-huh. Show me, Stanley. Oh, my bad. My name is Stanley. Any horror movie recommendations? How old are you, by the way? It depends on that, too. Like, above 18, or...
You see, Stanley, I've been reflecting on the right. Stanley Parable
there's
and
a movie
about
called
how roundly disappointing
Autopsy
this
ultra-deluxe
version
Very
has
terrifying.
Turned out to be. The original Stanley Parable was a landmark.
Dead silence.
And any new content for it should live up to that legacy. So forget this ultra-deluxe nonsense. I say we take
again.
It one step Whoa. Even further. Whoa. Which is why I'm very proud to announce for the first time ever the Stanley Parable 2.
What? The end is never a,
yes,
the end.
Yes, you see,
again.
Isn't this far superior to a measly re-release with a few minor additions? Think of all the new territory we'll cover with a fully fledged
what?
Sequel. An entirely new experience built from the ground up. Why there are so many possibilities?
Taste the sequel.
It could go in so many different directions. This is what fans have truly been asking
Robert,
for.
Robert, what's going on, man?
Calling it the Stanley Parable 2 is just so much catchier than Ultra Deluxe, don't you think? Ultra Deluxe? What does it even mean? But the Stanley Parable 2, now that's an artistic statement right there.
Uh-huh.
It's future-oriented. It screams progress and innovation and long-term franchising potential.
Game development office. They're back two doors. More TSP, better TSP. Color red leverage. Okay, cool. This is all very cool, chat. I don't think I've played a game quite like this. It's actually very incredible.
Now, to be clear, I haven't quite nailed down what exactly the Stanley Parable 2
Never
is
watched
going
it before.
To be. But let's take a look at some of the features I've been developing for
That movie
it.
was
I
terrifying.
But if I can
it.
Loosely organize a handful of interesting concepts, that surely the game will sort of naturally spring up around them.
Uh-huh.
It'll all work itself out. Game development is much more of a fuzzy magic than anything scientific or logical, really.
What else? Did you watch The Descent? That's a good movie. The sequel kind of sucked, but the main one was... Sequels are good. Portal 2, Half-Life 2, Arkham Asylum 2, Divinity, Original Sin 2, Doom 2, Aladdin, Return of Jaffer, Dark Souls 2. Okay, cool. This way to the show floor. New features! Okay. On Billy. Okay. Oh, there we go. Here we go, chat. New content! Oh, wow.
Here we are. Go on. Try out some of the new features.
Uh-huh. What do I type? What do I try? The Stanley Parable to Reassurance Bucket. No screenshots. Okay, there's a lot of stuff that we can check. Office decorations, the button that says name on the player that is playing. That's new. I don't know. No screenshots. What do you mean no screenshots? I can't take screenshots. Don't tell me what to do. New and easy. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and check the bucket. Alright, just do the bucket first. And then we can come down here. This is crazy. I did not expect...
A common complaint of the Stanley Parable was that it was confusing and paradoxical. That it engendered a chaotic sense of reckless despair in those who played it. Well, I'm happy to say that after much consideration, I've engineered a clever solution to this fundamental problem with the game. It's the Stanley Parable Reassurance Bucket. You see, Stanley, anytime you're holding the bucket, a sense of calm and ease will fill your mind and your heart. It's true.
Oh, there's the bucket.
As long as you hold onto the bucket, the many disorienting contradictions of the Stanley Parable will feel perfectly normal and perhaps even comforting. You may even come to long for the gentle embrace of jarring cognitive dissonance while the bucket is in your arms. And to be honest, it's a much more convenient solution for
me the new content.
Than actually redesigning the game to be less uncomfortable. Can you imagine what a pain in the ass that would be? Yes, the bucket is the perfect solution. Come on, give it a try.
I will, thank you. Why are you laughing?
Can you feel it? The glow of comfort, even in the face of crushing despair, must already be sweeping through your body.
You gotta listen to this guy ramble.
Can I say that I do believe the bucket lends you an air of charisma as well?
Can I put it back?
I think that just holding it has made you the slightest bit more attractive as a person.
Ooh.
The benefits of the bucket.
Yeah, more attractive as a person. Shut up, man. You're lying.
All this and more awaits you in the Stanley Parable 2.
Oh, is that right? Alright, put it down. Okay, there we go. It's open. Bucket for life. Let's go. You're my new friend now. I'm gonna call you Bucky.
Does anyone give out awards for most enjoyable bucket in a video game? That really should be an award if it isn't already.
Alright, Chad, we're gonna call him Bucky. So we could go over there, but that looks like a bigger area. Should we go check that area out real quick? Hear your name in the... Ooh, I don't know. Imagine if they actually...
For the Stanley Parable 2, asked myself, what do players really want?
Oh, shit.
And of course, the first and most obvious answer is that they want to be individually recognized and validated as people. So with that in mind, my first addition to the game is this button, which speaks the name of the person playing the game. Isn't that wonderful?
Mm-hmm. Can I not press it? Road to perfect button. Hear yours today. I don't know, chat. I don't know if I want to do that. Imagine if it has access to computer files and stuff. I don't know. Craig, have a good night. Catch you later. I'm gonna... Hold on. What I'm gonna do is a little safety precaution, okay? I'm gonna do this, and we'll see. If nothing happens, then I'll put it back. Hold on. I wanna see what happens. I'm sure it's the game's name. Hold on. Let's see.
I've clarified. Right now, the button only says the name Jim. But of course, in the final game, this button will say your name, whatever name that is. Here, okay. Let's have you role play as Jim all to right. Really simulate right, I'm the Jim. Full I'm experience yes, of this feature. Just play along. I promise you'll love it. Uh-huh. Okay, here we go. Let's take a deep breath, clear your mind, forget whoever you are,
don't and forget simply to change become your clocks. A person oh, the time Jim. Resets.
I want you to imagine yourself living as Jim. Sleeping and waking as Jim. Falling in love and being heartbroken as Jim. Seizing all of the world's possibilities
so
as Jim.
So the time is going to go 1 hour forward or 1 hour back? I forgot.
Into dust. Do you feel it deeply? Are you really, truly Jim right now? If so,
I think it's
then
gonna go
please
back, right?
Step
an hour?
Forward and press the button.
Or hour forward. Oh, it, okay, forward. So I'm going to have less time to sleep then. God damn.
Jim.
Yes, you see? What a thrill, what a rush. That was you. The button uh-huh. described you. Do it again, do it again.
Oh my God, do it again. Do it again. No, I won't want to.
It hits even harder the second time. If this were the only new feature in the Stanley Parable 2, it would still be worth the money.
Uh-huh.
Let's take a break from the Jim button. I'm too emotionally drained from all of this personal validation. Whoa there, cowboy. Sometimes a person can be too much Jim.
Jim.
I'm putting the Jim button Jim. Away.
No. No, my Jim button. No.
Jim.
No. God damn it, narrator. I hate you, man. You took my gym button away. I hate you. Alright, we gotta go. That's just crazy. I can't believe you would do that, Chad. I just can't believe it.
I suppose I could allow only people named Jim to play the Stanley Parable 2. That would actually save me the work
not
of
the
finishing
gym button.
This feature.
They took away my button. Merch. Ooh, merch. You guys ready? Get some merch. Let's hop. I can't go in. Are you kidding me? The button that says Jim. Okay, so what else we haven't seen? Oh, the straight. Okay, we gotta go straight. That's the only content that we haven't seen yet. Oh, there's something back here too. Hold on, let me go check this.
Okay, I'll be honest, I haven't yet decided on this one. Uh-huh. I think that in the new version, the office could use a bit of decoration, like balloons. But I'm undecided on Get Well Someday and Happy 12th Birthday. Which would you go with?
Get Well Someday. Happy 12th Birthday. Step niece.
You know, sometimes when you solicit another person's opinion, it makes you realize that you knew which one you actually really wanted all along. Get Well Someday it is.
What? Dude, I didn't even select that. Oh, come on. This guy's just pissing me off for no reason.
Or actually, maybe I should have gone with... No. No, I've made my decision. We're moving on.
Uh-huh. Okay, I want to see what's back here. Collectibles. So the other door basically lets you come in here. Okay, the jump circle.
You know what?
New content.
Let's bring the jump circle back for Stanley Parable 2 as well. It's uh-huh. a... Oh, wait. You already spent all your jumps the first time we saw the jump circle.
Right.
Hmm. Oh, well. I suppose it can just be a
I
nice
got,
decorative
my
piece,
neighbor.
Then.
Gotcha. Awesome. Can I jump? Let me jump! Okay, we can't jump. And I'm still holding the bucket. That's wild. Okay, we could go upstairs. We're not gonna do that. Let's take a look. Now free, new plus easy achievement. It just works. I can't believe it's that simple. Get free achievement. Get yours right now. Alright, so what else we have here? What's up here? This is crazy. Like, I feel like... What if I can't come back here again? Expo Hall 2 guide. My God. Free achievement. The map says the name of the player. It's huge. Alright, you know what? We're gonna go ahead with the easy achievements first. I wish we could jump, but you know what? It's okay. Pull the lever, receive your achievement, no more steps. Just works.
Now, here's something special. You remember that broken test achievement that got left in the game on accident? Well, yeah. I'm developing a technology to simply give you the achievement. Yes.
Okay.
You see, you'll come to this lever, and when you pull it, the achievement... Okay, perhaps I should have clarified. This is technology that will exist. Right now, the achievement is still fully broken.
Why would you...
Wizard Stanley,
bruh.
But I guarantee it will be fixed in the sequel. To at last
give it to me now.
The hordes of ravenous fans all over the world who have been uproariously demanding this feature. Gamers, we hear you, and I promise it will happen.
Wow. Alright, so much for a easy achievement, huh? Alright, we gotta go back. Stupid narrator. Oh my god. Alright, here we go. So we're
what
done
else?
With that.
What other exhibits haven't we seen yet?
Uh-huh. Up here. Let's check this out. Can you find them? Can you find them? Okay, let's go find... Ooh, what is that?
Ah, collectibles. Now it's a real video game. In the Stanley Parable 2, you'll run around gathering up these miniature Stanley figurines. Uh-huh. And what's truly innovative is that there will be no reward for collecting all of them. I don't want to stifle the intrinsic joy of watching a number go up. You simply collect all of them, and then you move the hell on with your unremarkable life.
Stanley! That's me. 1 out of 6. Collect... Oh, we gotta find them all. Anyways.
God, it really is the worst when you collect everything in a video game and then they give you a big fancy reward for it. Absolutely tragic.
I finally unbanned from Roblox. I got 22 takes because my internet bestie thought I died. Oh my god. If you created one horror game, what would it be? Oof. I can't think of one right on top of my head. Wait, what is that? The infinite hole. It won't end. Alright, we're not gonna go to the hole, but that's something that we'll test at the end. Shit. What? If I had to create a horror game, what would it be that was not created? I don't know. Ooh. Exit. What is this? I'm thinking
right.
Like what?
Have you seen everything you wanted to?
Oh no,
ready
no,
ready to
no,
move
no.
on now?
No. Thanks for reminding me, pal. I appreciate it. I'm not ready to move on. Not yet. Okay. So the exit is that way. We're not gonna go there. Collectibles. We did get the collectible. We're gonna go ahead and go through the infinite hole. See what that's all about, you know? There's something about this hole just dragging me along the way. Rim, opening surrounding area, depth. Okay. Alright, you guys ready?
Stanley, here's an idea that I'm truly fond of. It's never been done before in a video game.
Okay.
This is, in fact, a hole that you can fall down forever. That's
forever.
Right. Infinite falling. Uh-huh. You can fall until the end of time, if you like. A stunning leap forward for video games as a medium.
Right. But can I get out of it, though? Oh, nah. It looks like a whale from The Ring. No! I slipped and fell.
You see? Isn't it wonderful? One of my more ingenious concoctions, if I do say so.
Now, are you kidding?
Since you've gotten to see the infinite hole, you can press the teleport button to pop back up to the top, and we can continue onward.
Teleport button. Okay, no, I'm gonna keep falling. What's in the bucket? It's an empty bucket.
Now, I don't mean to be a bummer, but I do recommend you use the teleport button to go back to the top.
What if I don't want to go back?
You can do it on the sooner rather than later spectrum of things.
What if I don't want to go up? Maybe I'm enjoying this, man. Right, Chad? I think we're enjoying this.
Okay, Stanley. I don't know quite how to say this tactfully, but it's possible that I slightly exaggerated the infinite nature of the hole. Is it a very, very deep hole? To be certain it is. It's an extremely deep hole.
Oh, so it's not infinite.
I don't want anyone to say that it isn't an astonishingly deep hole. It is. Is it infinite?
I'm enjoying
that. It sort of depends on your definition of infinity. From one perspective, the infinite is merely philosophical in nature. It's more of a...
Oh!
Okay, well, good for you. You found the bottom of the hole.
Bottom of the hole, chat. W's Stanley. In the chat.
Liar and cheat, and you're so clever.
Oh, I am clever.
I think the issue here is just that you're unusually...
The hole wasn't even a minute long, dude.
What normal person actually wants to fall infinitely?
Me?
I figured the hole was as deep as anyone would actually need. Don't you put this on me. Maybe you're the problem. Look, things got a little heated there. I think we both said some things we didn't
mean. Can I get out of here?
Why don't we just put all this behind us and agree to just call the hole mostly infinite?
Mostly infinite.
If that works for you, then mostly. Go ahead and press the teleport button to warp up to the top of the hole and we can move on.
Okay.
I'll just be up here when you're ready.
Maybe I'm enjoying my time down in the hole, you know? Just saying, maybe I'm enjoying it. Some alone time finally, you know? Not this guy always just yapping in your ears.
Great, now, I'm very excited to show you even more of my ideas for the sequel.
Okay, let's go. What video games have you played? Oh, a lot. We played a lot. Wait, where do I go? What? How do I leave? Oh, there we go. I didn't even see the stairs. He's so mean. I love it. We played a lot of them. At least 6, 7. Could be more. But you know what? This game is way above my expectation. I didn't think it would be actually this good. It's completely different than any other games I've ever played. Oh, we haven't checked upstairs either. So let's go upstairs, check it out, see what we got. Settings, champion. Oh, what's that's new? Okay, let's see. Epilogue.
An epilogue would be fun, wouldn't it, Stanley? Yes, yes, it would go at the end of the, well, we'll figure that out later.
I just came back down here. Never mind. All right, let's go ahead and try to collect my other endings as well. Where are the stairs? Wait, where are the stairs? What? Is this actually... second game or no, it's the first. It's they're just calling it Stanley Parable 2, but it's all a joke. New poop killer. Yeah, okay. Every time I hear this early, I just hope she stubs her toes. Okay, so I feel like we saw some stairs, but the stairs are gone completely. I'm just gonna keep going this way then. Here we go. Infinity. Oh. Oh. Do I just go the whole entrance? All right, here we go. What? What? Oh, come on. You're telling me I can't go into the hole? How many endings? I have no idea. This one we already got, I think, at least... like 7, 8 endings so far, maybe. Infinite hole. Okay, so this is where I was going last time, trying to get out. And then I found a staircase. Okay, we gotta go upstairs. Not over there, but this way. Oh, there we go.
I
I'm a fan of her. Aren't you and your sister like same age, or is she like older, younger? Oh, settings world champ. Oh, come on, man. Why is this locked? Alright, you know what, chat? I think we're done watching everything here. I think we're actually done. Alright, let's get out of here. Alright. You guys ready? Ready to hit the exit? This might be the end, chat. This might actually be the Ultra Deluxe DLC pack. Someone left their briefcase right there. That's kind of trippy. Oh, no screenshots.
So, Stanley, what do you think? Do you like all of the new features? Yes, I know it's not exactly clear yet how exactly these features will come together as one single coherent video game, but I can feel it in my soul. It's going to work. There's definitely a good game in there somewhere. Say, let's do an experiment. I'll arrange these new features together, and we'll see whether or not it coheres into a meaningful gameplay experience. Okay, are you ready? Here it is. I give you the Stanley Parable 2.
Oh, wow. Oh, there's a big hole.
I mean, there's potential here, right?
It's yeah, a deep hole. Of,
okay, never mind.
We're twins, but totally
Hold on.
Different.
Let me do a different arrangement.
About, oh, you're a minute
okay,
older.
Yes, yes, this is much better. I feel God. Good about this. Here we go. Version 2.
Version 2. That's probably worse than
Who
the first
Who am I kidding,
time.
Stanley? This isn't a coherent video game at all. It's a lot of gags. And I do very much enjoy creating gags, but they don't add up to anything. I wanted more than anything to create a sequel that would capture all the magic of the first game. I wanted fans to love it. No matter how good these gags are, they wouldn't stand on their own. They would need the structure and the gameplay of the original. Wait, maybe that's it. I can take the original Stanley Parable and simply, well, insert a few of my new features into it. Tastefully, of course.
Okay.
With respect. With care for the vision and integrity of the original game.
That's a big
would
one.
Would it possibly work?
Damn.
I suppose it could. But it would need a really, really tremendous title screen. A title screen that says with bold and uncompromising conviction, this is the Stanley Parable 2. Let me see if I can whip something up. All right, perfect. Go ahead.
That was
Take
fast.
A look.
Show me. That's the title screen. Oh, nah. Wait, what? So we're officially into the Stanley Parable 2. All right. Let's see what we got.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a...
I'm skipping. Okay, so here we are. Did anything change in the office, though?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go
we
to
got
the
those
meeting
balloons
Perhaps
now.
He had simply missed a memo.
And the bucket,
Stanley
too.
Stanley picked up the bucket.
Uh-huh, we got balloons, buckets. Oh, it doesn't say new content anymore.
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door on his left.
Okay, I'm gonna follow his instructions this time.
Still no one was here.
Uh-huh.
Stanley needed the bucket's warmth and comfort now more than ever. Perhaps his boss's office was where he coming to a staircase, Stanley and the bucket walked upstairs to the boss's office.
What if the bucket is cold? Bucky will keep Sam safe. Right. As long as I'm with Bucky, nothing
Stepping
will...
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned
Mika, what's up?
To discover Hi. Not an indication of any human life. Crushed by the weight of this revelation, Stanley may have broken down into an emotional dumpster fire if not for the soothing presence of the bucket.
Uh-huh.
Even now, in his darkest of hours, did the bucket's warmth and guiding light pierce the dark clouds of confusion and chaos. It would be with him always.
Right.
The bucket would. And he knew it. The two of them were inseparable.
Inseparable.
At this yep. point, Stanley was so absorbed in the tender spiritual connection he shared with the bucket that he Say didn't Bucky. Notice the keypad behind the boss's desk.
He has a name! It's
Nor
Bucky!
In his bliss of simply being near the bucket, did he have any notion that the pin number for the keypad was 2845. But Stanley guessed the correct code by sheer luck. Was it that the bucket knew all along? Was the bucket guiding him?
Yes.
This is certainly the most logical explanation.
Uh-huh. Yep. Bucky is guiding me. Oh.
You found one of them. One of the miniature Stanley figurines. Remember, no reward for collecting all of these. Only the intrinsic pleasure of a job well done.
Gotcha.
You can't buy that sort of happiness, Stanley. God knows I've tried. So, I implore you to savor each and every moment you come across one of these beautiful figurines.
Okay, thank you. I will. This game is crazy. I'm actually falling asleep. Like, I'm
the elevator raced downward, plummeting towards an unknown fate. It would be all Stanley could do to keep himself together,
yeah.
if not for the bucket. Soothing him, comforting him, reassuring
him. No wonder it took him 2 years to
record
the audio.
He would be all right.
You can see why?
The bucket is here for you, Stanley. Everything will be fine.
You'd go crazy if you tried to like record it in like 2 days, you know?
Stanley and the bucket walked straight ahead through the large door that read, Mind Control Facility.
Yeah, I got Bucket with me. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid of anybody. I got my bucket, my Bucky with me.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens.
Uh-huh.
What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley and the bucket both wondered to themselves.
Okay. Now, Stanley and his friend Bucky moving. Oh. Oh, it's actually nothing changed. Okay, cool. Wait, wasn't there a
The monitors jumped to life, and Stanley nearly dropped the bucket in shock. Everyone in the office was being videotaped, monitored like guinea pigs. The bucket had never seen anything like this, and it very nearly burst into tears as Stanley cradled
The bucket burst into
reassuring
tears?
Reassuring it that everything would be fine.
Aw, don't worry, Bucky. Oh, don't worry, Bucky. Yeah, it's gonna be okay.
Was the bucket under the mind control facility's influence as well? Had the bucket been told to do things it didn't wish to do? What kinds of things does a bucket want to do or not want to do in the first place?
The bucket, I'm sure the bucket didn't want to be Granny's piss bucket, right? Mind.
No! He screamed into the bucket. He couldn't accept it. His
oh, no.
own life in someone else's control?
No,
never!
Bucky!
He squeezed
no.
the bucket tighter. His one friend in the entire world. At this point, he could trust no one except
Bucky leaking
the
water.
Bucket.
At least I'm not alone.
But here was the proof. The heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions. Happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he and the bucket would dismantle the controls for good. Two best friends, Stanley and the bucket, up against the world.
All right.
They high-fived in a really cool way. And the bucket made a sassy comment about taking down the system.
Okay, we high-fived in a cool way. Here we go. We turned down the operation.
Stanley and the bucket waited in blackness. Was it over? Yes,
They had done it. Stanley and the Bucket had defeated their greatest and darkest enemy, freed themselves from the tyrannical grip of the evil mind control machine. Freedom was now mere moments away. Excitedly, the two of them began to discuss the kind of life they wanted to live once they stepped through this massive door. The Bucket wanted to learn to roller skate. Stanley wanted to sneeze in every country.
Just play this game and just go
to sleep. Both of them wanted to begin watching a movie, any movie, but then stop it halfway through and begin watching it in reverse from the end. It was a simple life they envisioned, but it was one they'd lived together, with one another to lean on, to trust, to support, and...
Oh,
nah. What? Wait. What was happening?
No,
why
please.
Why had the door stopped?
Let me out of here,
was
please.
Stanley and the Bucket not about to be freed?
Oh,
an unbearable silence filled the room, lingering in uncertainty. Until finally the truth hit Stanley square in the face. This building did not want the Bucket to leave. Even the facility itself recognized the incredible calming presence of the Bucket. Needed the soothing warmth of the Bucket.
No, not my friend. Not Bucky.
No,
please.
Stanley can't leave this place.
I can't leave
Bucket. Not while he has such a precious bucket in his arms.
Oh, well.
Not while this building has anything to say about it. Stanley realized he would never again leave this very room. But at least he has the bucket. To be trapped eternally in darkness isn't really so bad, Stanley thought to himself. As long as I have my bucket with me, right? I'll be okay, won't I? Stanley gulped. Very soon now, he was about to find out.
About to find out? What? I am falling asleep from this game. Holy crap. About to find out what? Oh, now we gotta find out again.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
What time
Stanley
is it?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed him. Stanley lifted the bucket into his arms, and a wave of comfort rushed over him.
Okay.
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door.
This
was not the correct way to the meeting room, but Stanley had felt the bucket calling to him, telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to be. And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct? Was this better than the meeting room? Yes, Stanley thought to himself. Yes, perhaps it truly was. How insightful the bucket. No, never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room.
Do we gotta go back to the meeting room? So it's basically all the endings that we got. You take the bucket with you and it's gonna be an alternate ending. Every single ending. It's pretty wild.
And so the two of them detoured through the maintenance section and walked straight ahead to the opposite door. Oh, good, Stanley. I'm glad you found your way here. I knew you'd find this place eventually. You see, your friends and I are concerned for you, Stanley. We've come together here because we care about you very much. It's this bucket you're carrying around everywhere. The bucket isn't even from the original Stanley Parable. It's just sequel content. We're the ones that matter, Stanley. Classic characters from the first game, like the Adventure Line and the Broom Closet. Because that's what fans want from a sequel. They want more of their favorite jokes, not this bucket that they've never seen before. Yes, I know I'm the one who gave you the bucket, but you're spending too much time with it. Don't you want another story involving the Adventure Line? We could make the Adventure Line go somewhere new. Yes, yes, that's what the fans want. Let's do it.
Oh, let's go. Let's go.
Whee! Look at that wacky line. Who knows where it'll go off to next? Oh, and it played some silly music as well.
Okay.
Now,
there we go.
This is what the Stanley Parable is all about. Don't
Come
you
on,
remember
Don't
all those
music.
Great jokes from
kidding?
The original dialogue?
Also, Stanley is addicted to drugs and hookers.
Yes. It's as classic now as it was back then. Let's do it for the fans,
well,
Stanley. Let's give them
character.
More content exactly like this. But if we want to do that, you're going to have to give something up. Don't you get it, Stanley? We need to get rid of the bucket. That's why I'm very proud to introduce a brand new character. This is the Bucket Destroyer.
Nah. No.
I think it'll make a wonderful new addition to the rich lore
no.
of the Stanley Parable.
Bucky, true, Bucky's my friend. It also was not I'm in not the original game, that.
But it's such a well-fleshed-out character with
no
so much
way.
Personality that to me, it already feels as though it's been part of the cast all along.
Shut
Don't
up, man. I'm not doing it. Not Bucky. No.
Can you guess what the Bucket Destroyer does?
It destroys Surely the bucket.
You don't need me to spell it out for you. Go ahead now, Stanley.
No.
Say
no,
goodbye
no.
to the bucket.
No.
And then pop it into the machine when you're ready.
No! Please! Oh, no.
Now listen to me. It's crucial
I can't even
that you
leave.
Give it the bucket. I
no.
don't know what the Bucket Destroyer will do if it can't destroy your bucket. Destroying buckets is all it knows. That is its singular personality trait. Sure, I can hear
no.
you saying, how does a character with only one personality trait deserve to join the pantheon of beloved Stanley Parable characters? Well, you see,
I can't
if you were
leave,
to really explore the Bucket Destroyer,
you
would see that its desire to crush buckets is so densely loaded with complexity and nuance that it's really like 10 personality traits. What other object in this game can you even say that about?
Chad, can
the
you
broom
guys hear
closet?
It?
Certainly
Bucky's
not.
Crying.
I wonder what sort of Bucket
Bucky's
Destroyer merchandise
crying.
The fans will be clamoring for after this. Okay, the Bucket Destroyer is getting very upset now. You'll have to hurry
I
and
won't.
Feed it. We can't get back to the classic Stanley Parable characters like the Adventure Line or the Bucket
He's
Destroyer until you crush that damn bucket. Oh. Quickly now. The fans are waiting. Do it, the fans, Stanley.
No.
Give the fans what they want.
No.
Hurry and...
Ow. Flashbang. Are we dead? What happened? What?
Bucket Destroyer, my prized creation.
Oh, the Bucket Destroyer is
so
gone.
Potential.
W's
we
in the chat. Let's go. Bucky's alive.
Spellbinding stories.
Bucky is alive.
All of it squandered now. Goodbye, new friend.
New friend.
For the moment in time that you were here, you were magnificent.
Uh huh. Let's go. Nobody can separate me and Bucky. Can I move on? Wow. I did not expect this game to have like such crazy you know, crazy new things. It's actually wild.
I can't wait to tell this story to my coworkers, Stanley thought. How amusing they'll find it. Oh, won't we all just laugh and laugh at the time I thought everyone had gone missing? The confusion and the chaos all seemed to melt away as Stanley embraced the bucket.
I wonder what the creators of this game were actually thinking when they made it. Like, were they all high or...
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door on his left.
Ooh, alright, let's go. I don't want to come back to this game again. Like, I just wanted to finish it tonight completely, you know? How can we find them? Bottom text. Wait, what? Can I change? Small floating objects appear across the office. There will be a reward for finding them all. Oh, there will be. Okay, that's good to know. Swiggity, what's up?
Coming to a staircase, Stanley and the bucket walked upstairs to the boss's office.
No, we went downstairs. Oh, there we go. I knew
Another
it.
Another miniature Stanley figurine.
I knew it.
This, you know, there really must be a snappier name for these things. What about mini-stans? Stanley figs? Oh, what about Stanlerines? Yes, I think I like that. Another Stanlerine under your belt.
All right, here we go.
But Stanley just couldn't do it. He considered the possibility of facing his boss, admitting he had left his post during work hours. He might be fired for that. And in such a competitive economy, why had he taken that risk? All because he believed
everyone
had
vanished. Oh no, it's gonna be the loop!
His boss would think he was crazy.
Oh crap.
Something occurred to Stanley. Maybe, he thought to himself,
maybe I can't even leave
I
now.
Am crazy.
I'm stuck in a loop.
He looked down at the bucket in his arms. Am I crazy? He asked the bucket. The bucket returned his gaze, but said nothing at all. That's strange, Stanley thought. Usually the bucket is a source of guidance and wisdom for me in difficult times such as these. He held the bucket close, yet felt none of its familiar reassurance and comfort. And that's when Stanley realized, this isn't my bucket.
It's just a normal, everyday bucket. Someone
Wait,
else's bucket, perhaps.
How did
this
is I not my
end
bucky?
Up with someone else's bucket?
Oh,
this
no.
This is all terribly wrong. Surely no good would come from this. Who knows what sorts of bizarre hallucinations Stanley might experience
I lost my bucky.
Without the psychologically grounding
Ooga
presence
Booga,
of his
to follow
bucket.
Over on TikTok. Appreciate it.
Now he noticed the rooms were repeating, which was, of course, very odd.
Oh, no.
Now he felt himself floating off
Someone
the
stole my bucky.
Oh,
no!
He exclaimed. Without my bucket, I've gone truly mad. Where is it? I must find it.
I must find
Far
it.
Far off in the distance now, he
Bucky,
heard,
can you hear me, Bucky?
Him.
Stanley! Stanley, it's me, the bucket.
Could it truly be? He rushed forward from room to room, passing
Wait,
by
bucket,
one
I...
bucket after the next.
Oh,
None
no.
of them were his. None of them were his special bucket.
No.
Come to me, Stanley. Find me.
He had to find the bucket. He had to return to his old friend. It was
oh,
the only
God.
Way to truly restore his sanity. And then suddenly, he froze dead in his tracks. He knew where the voice of the bucket had been coming from.
Uh-huh.
The real bucket was inside of him all
inside
along.
Inside of me? Wait, what?
It was incredibly painful. Stanley
I appreciate it, Booga Booga.
And blacked out.
Glad you liked the live stream. Oh, nah. So we lost
This is
Bucky.
A story of a woman named Mariella.
I don't care about Mariella. Shut up, man. I'm worried about Bucky.
Mariella woke up on a day like any other. She arose, got dressed, picked up her bucket of comfort and security, and walked to her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man
What?
Who had
She's holding my bucket.
Town, talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk. Right away, she knew what the problem was. This man had no bucket. Of course he'd gone mad, ranting and raving about a narrator describing all of his actions and how everything is predetermined and free will is an illusion and it's all just a video game. It could all have been prevented if only he'd
video
taken
game.
His
oh.
bucket with him. Perhaps he didn't even realize he'd forgotten his bucket.
She stole the bucket.
How cruel the world can be, Mary.
I'm trying to imagine this in Arnold's voice.
But of course, she had no time for this. There were a
Come with me
of
if we want to live.
Problems she would soon have
no,
to confront at work.
Shit,
her
I forgot.
Would provide absolute guidance
I can't do his
and
voice.
Total clarity on everything. Heck yes, she thought to herself. My life kicks ass. And she backflipped all the way to work.
Backflipped? What? Tell me I'm gonna get my bucky back. Please. Please.
How long was I sitting there? Stanley wondered to himself. Minutes? Days?
Bucky!
Warmth spread through Stanley's arms.
Uh-huh.
With the bucket in his arms again, he was home.
Uh-huh.
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest. This was not the correct way to the meeting room.
Shut up,
Stanley.
Stanley
had felt the bucket
I mean, shut up, narrator.
Him, telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to be. And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct? No, never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room.
No, said the bucket. Don't go to the meeting room. Go somewhere else. The cargo
what?
Lift, yes. Go there. Go to the cargo lift. Good, said the bucket. Now ride the lift all the way to the top. There's something up there I need you to do.
Stanley did not question why or how this bucket was speaking to him. It should have alarmed him, of course, because buckets can't talk. But Stanley chose not to think about this
Ooh,
obvious fact. He was firmly convinced that the bucket had spoken to him, and he unthinkingly did whatever the bucket asked.
Oh, danger everywhere. Wait a second. Oh, we've never been here before. Now that I think about it, even without the bucket. New emote idea for Bucky the Bucket. Oh, you know what? Yeah. Remember that, okay? We're gonna have to make a new emote for Bucky. He's part of the community now, chat. Danger everywhere. Here we go. This is one of the endings that I haven't gotten
no,
before.
No, stop. Look there on the wall, you see? There's a sign right there. It says, no buckets past this point.
No,
Stanley,
shut up, man.
How could you think it was okay to bring the bucket here? Unless... What if the problem is that you actually don't know what is a bucket and what isn't a bucket? I suppose that would explain a lot about your behavior up to this point. Which, if that's true, well, my goodness, I think we have to do something about it.
This misunderstanding could have dire consequences on the entire rest of the game if not addressed quickly and properly.
Right.
So much of the impact of the story is dependent on your understanding of what is and isn't.
Oh my god, this guy's rambling again.
Step in here for a moment.
Okay. I'm stepping in. What is a bucket? Oh, not. Is this a bucket? Is this?
Now then, I'm going to run you through some test scenarios, and you'll tell me whether or not the thing I'm showing you is a bucket.
Like a bucket quiz.
Simply enough, right? This should tell us everything we'll ever need to know about what is or is not a bucket.
Uh-huh.
Okay, let's begin. Item one. Is this a bucket?
Yes. Should I do no? Yeah, I kind of want to find out what happens, but no. Imagine if they take my Bucky away from me.
Incorrect. It is a hologram of a bucket, not an actual bucket.
What? What the fuck? Wait, what? How's that a hologram?
Item two. Is this a bucket?
No.
Correct. It is a 3D printed recreation of a bucket, not an
rigged
actual
game
bucket.
Show. Exactly. Okay, we got it. We got this one, right? Next! What do we got? What do we got?
Item three. Is this a bucket? Incorrect. This is a bucket.
Bruh. How's that? It looks the same.
Item four. Is this a bucket?
Yeah, that's a bucket, man. Yep.
Correct. This is a tractor and not a bucket. To be honest, I just sort of put this one in here as a gimme, but I was starting to get concerned that even this might be too much for you. Thank you for not making me look like an idiot. Okay, next one.
Wow, this guy. He's just saying whatever the hell he wants to me.
Is this a bucket?
No, man. How many times do I gotta do this?
Incorrect. This is a bucket.
What? Oh no.
Item six. Is this a bucket?
It's like asking, oh, is this an ice cream? Yes, it's an ice cream. I identify myself as an ice cream. I guess this bucket identifies itself as a bucket too. Or maybe not a bucket. I don't know.
Trick question. Both. Gotcha.
Oh no. Alright, next. What do we got next?
Item. Wait, hold on. I can't find the next one. Let me see. Oh, should great. Be around here somewhere.
Uh-huh. What? There's an...
Okay, you and I both know there isn't anything here. And I don't appreciate the implication that nothing is a bucket when we both clearly know that a bucket is something, and therefore nothing could possibly be something.
This
unless,
guy's gaslighting
in your twisted
like
mind,
crazy.
Have you somehow convinced yourself that a bucket is nothing?
Yes.
Answer me straight, Stanley.
Yes.
Do you believe that nothing is a bucket?
If nothing identifies itself as bucket, then it is bucket, right? Hey, it's 2024. You can be whatever the hell you want. Yes.
You know what? I'm too confused to even sort it out. I've lost all sense of perspective. What is
what?
A bucket? What isn't a bucket? Mere moments ago, I could answer these questions with confidence. And yet now I'm somewhat adrift. Do any of us know what a bucket is? Am I a bucket?
Do you identify yourself as
Stanley,
a bucket?
I can't keep doing this. I'm losing myself, and myself was all I ever had to begin with. I'm afraid the bucket is threatening to tear our relationship apart. I can't help that.
What relationship?
But I'm going to erase all buckets from the game.
No,
entirely.
Don't you dare.
Okay, here we go.
No!
What happened? Is everything gone? Why did everything disappear? Wait, was everything a bucket? Every single thing in the game was a bucket. Oh my god, I had no idea. How could... except me. I'm not a bucket after all.
No, you're a
and
bucket
you,
too.
And you, Stanley, you're still here. You're not a bucket either.
Oh no, what happened to Bucky? Bucky!
Yes, I actually feel much more at ease right now.
Imagine if Bucky's gone.
To get some clarity on that issue. But it doesn't change the fact that we haven't got a game. So, tell you what. I'll reset everything and we'll put back all of the buckets, okay?
Okay,
and we'll know that it's all a bucket. But if you run into anyone else, maybe don't mention that. Who knows what that information might do to a person? Uh-huh. All right, here we go.
Okay. Oh, yo,
wait, Stanley,
Bucky's gonna be back.
Am I sure that the orders stopped coming in?
Bucky!
Stanley picked up the bucket and smiled. Mm-hmm. He'd never be alone again, not truly alone, not with the bucket around. Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, but Stanley had felt the bucket calling to him, telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to be.
Uh-huh.
And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct? Never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room.
No, said the bucket. Don't go to the meeting room. Go somewhere else. The cargo lift. Yeah, good, said the bucket.
All right, I'm gonna
now
go up
ride
there.
The lift all the way to the top. There's something up there I
wait,
need
Wait, there's
you
right
to do.
There.
Stanley
there's
did
some,
not question
there's right there. You guys see that?
I
need
to
collect.
To
no!
It, but Stanley feared that any path he walked might lead to the separation of himself and the bucket, his dearest friend. So he threw himself to his death, that they might die in one another's arms. How deeply touching.
Well, that's another ending too. Okay. But you guys saw that, right? There was another one floating.
I can't wait to tell this story to my co-workers, Stanley thought.
How romantic.
How amusing they'll find it. Oh, won't we? The good old bucket. Just Stanley and the bucket. Off on another thrilling adventure together.
Better story. Way better story than
Twilight. This was not the correct way to the meeting room. But Stanley had felt the bucket calling to him,
love
telling
gorilla
him
tag.
That
Hi.
The employee lounge
doing?
Was simply the place to be. Uh-huh. And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct? No, never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room.
No,
said the bucket.
Don't go to the meeting room. Go somewhere else. The cargo lift, yes. Go there. Go to the cargo lift.
Oh, there we go. Ooh. Whoa, what is that? Ain't no way. Okay. Here we go, we got collectible!
I'm going back to the name of these little Stanley figurines, and now I'm torn between Stanlerines and Figlies. What do you think, Stanley? What name better encapsulates the intrinsic sense of happiness that you get from seeing a small number in the corner of your screen go up by one?
Uh-huh.
Let me sit on it. I'm sure it will come to me.
Have you done the option where you stay in the employee lounge? We haven't really stayed in the employee lounge. I mean, we don't get an ending. We could just stand there and he's gonna keep yapping and then that's it. Okay, what is this? Oh. Oh. Oh, okay. This is new, I suppose. Hello. Is anybody down here? Oh my gosh. A lot of cassettes, huh?
This is day number 295, tape number... I don't
there
even
are
know.
So many different endings. It's like 19 track. Endings, as somebody said, right?
Nothing.
But I'm not sure if they even considered the Ultra Deluxe Edition.
The longer I study this bucket, the less sense anything makes.
Studying buckets, okay.
Yeah, you. Euphoria, I feel.
This is narrator sound system.
Every time I pick it up, mm-hmm. no matter how many times I've done it,
Zeus,
it's
welcome back.
Always
you got ice cream,
now
I'm craving ice cream.
Feeling.
Damn.
And the emptiness in my chest when I set it down. It doesn't make sense. There's no explanation for it. Still haven't figured out why I see the world so differently when this bucket
I know.
Is in my
You're
arms.
In love with the bucket.
Why everything feels so... What do I do with this treasure? I can monetize it.
Monetize? Oh, that's
it's
a granola bar.
The amounts of money people
chip,
will pay for
bar.
Even just an hour with the bucket. This is my golden ticket.
This guy has officially lost
but
his
I have
mind.
To be careful, because as soon as this gets out, there's going to be a target on my back. Even now, I don't know who might be trying to get.
Oh,
what's that? Who's there?
Too late, buddy.
Come, Borata.
Stanley Parable, the horror game? What? Oh, okay. So that was one ending as well. All right. So I don't think we got too many left right now. I think we can wrap it up in like 15
minutes.
Stanley
decided to go to the meeting room.
Where are we going today? The bucket asked.
I'm trying to wrap this up tonight. I don't want to come back to this game again.
Anywhere they went together would be.
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to
his chest. The bucket did it.
And entered the door.
Oh, I'm sure he did.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room.
Bucky, you naughty boy! You deserve some spankings.
Telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to be. And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be
stay
correct,
here for a little bit.
Was this
Let's
better than
says.
The meeting room? Yes, Stanley thought to himself. Yes, perhaps it truly was. Mm-hmm. How insightful the bucket turned out to be.
Oh, that's it. All right.
No, never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room.
All right, there was another ending. We gotta go across.
No,
said the bucket.
Don't go to the meeting room. Go somewhere else. The cargo lift, yes. Good, said the bucket. Now ride the lift all the way to the top. There's something up there I need you to do.
Okay.
Stanley did not question why or how this bucket was speaking to him. It should have alarmed him, of course, because buckets can't talk. But Stanley chose not to think about this obvious fact. He was firmly convinced that the bucket had spoken to him, and he unthinkingly did whatever the bucket asked.
Uh-huh. All right, here we go.
In here, said the bucket. Go into this dark room over here.
Dark
Stanley
room.
Once again obeyed blindly.
Dark room. I wonder what the bucket is planning, chat. Is Bucky actually my friend, or is he pretending to be my friend? Maybe he wasn't my friend all along. Oh.
Now pick up the phone, said the bucket. Pick up the phone, and it will take us back home, where we can go about life together.
Uh-huh. Ooh, flashbang.
This is the sad
Leanna,
story
hi.
Of a man named Stanley and his bucket. Once upon a time, I gave Stanley a bucket because I thought he was lonely and could use a friend. And
this
then, very distressingly, he began to believe the bucket could speak to him.
Got a TV, soundbar, a very small kitchen. Where's my bedroom? Hey, why the side eye, Ashley? What's going on? Huh? What do I do here? Hello? I've been pressing everything. Oh, there we go. Hello, Stanley. It's me, your bucket. Press Q to take me to work with you. Come here with me.
The Stanley Parable Reassurance Bucket was merely meant to provide the comforting glow of companionship.
Uh-huh.
It doesn't literally talk and give you orders. Whatever Stanley is hearing the bucket say to him is just in his head.
Hydrate. Press it to take me home with you.
Lately, I've been concerned about him. Wouldn't you be concerned as well? To see him delusional like this, obsessing over an inanimate metal object? I want to say something to him, but I don't know how I can convince him. I don't know if he'll listen to me.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'll try anyway. Stanley, can you hear me? Listen to me. It's just a bucket. It can't think. It can't
talk. No, it can't talk. His name is Bucky.
All it would ever truly do for you is effectively transfer a liquid from one location to a different location.
Oh, liquid, you say?
That's it. It doesn't do anything else.
Mm-hmm. Says you. Don't listen to the loud man. Press H for us to go back home.
You see,
He's not listening. He's still taking orders from the bucket. You know, once upon a time, it was me he took orders from. Me he trusted and listened to. Now all he cares about is this awful bucket. This stupid hunk of metal.
You're just jealous that you can't... You can't do what the bucket can make me do. You're just jealous, pal. Ignore anyone in your life except for me.
It's sad. I suppose he doesn't need me anymore. Mm-hmm. From now on, he's just going to cling to this bucket, this cold, empty bucket, this sort of shiny bucket. Well, I'll give it this. The bucket does have a nice shine to it.
You believe I'm real, don't you, Stanley? Press B to go back home. Let's go, Bucket.
Yes, I suppose on closer inspection, that it doesn't quite look like your average hardware store bucket. Uh-huh. It's just a little more, what am I trying to say?
Oh, it's growing on him as well.
More capable of transporting liquid.
Uh-huh.
Like it would be better at moving an amount of water from one room to another.
I know, right? You're finally starting to realize. Press B to relieve the same day with me over and over.
Oh my God, what am I saying? Better at carrying water from room to room. It's a bucket. It's literally just a bucket. Why do I feel some need to point out the ways in which it's so much more than just a regular bucket?
Find your own, buddy. Find your own.
Oh no, I'm having feelings. The bucket.
I knew that was coming.
No. What's going on?
I knew it.
Why do I want to be with the bucket? Hear what the bucket has to say. Do anything it asks. What's wrong with me? I don't understand.
Don't interrupt our bucket dinner. This would be less confusing. Date night with Bucky.
The bucket could tell me what to do in this troublesome situation.
Hey, the bucket's waiting. Bucky's waiting for me in the bed. What's going on?
Stanley, give me the bucket. Give it to
me. Find your own.
Give me the bucket, Stanley. I need it. Give it to me now. Give it or I'll...
What? He's trying to steal my Bucky. Go back to work, Stanley. Ain't no way. Are you kidding? Are you actually kidding? What happened? Was it all a dream? Ooh. There's the phone ringing. Hello?
Good morning. Thank you for contacting the Future Happiness Foundation. We are confirming your shipment of 1,327 cardboard boxes to your place of work. Can you verify that this is correct? Excellent. Your order will arrive shortly. Thank you again for contacting the Future Happiness Foundation.
Okay, thank you. Alright.
A good bucket. A strong bucket, a humble bucket, a committed bucket, a bucket of culture and distinction. Uh-huh. Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door on his left.
This is wild. Oh my God. Okay. We already went down, right?
Coming to a staircase, Stanley and the bucket walked upstairs to the boss's office.
Okay, we gotta go check every single area because we're looking for some collectibles. Oh, there we go! I knew it.
Close now, Stanley.
We need one more.
You've gotten all of the Figler and Marines. Very soon, you'll collect the last one.
Oh, I know.
And then the first number will equal the second number, and that will be it. We'll be different people by then. Different in the sense that we used to have none of them, and now we have them all. You can't go back to when you had no Figler and Marines. None of us can.
Right. Hey, thanks, man. Appreciate it. Money in the morning, money in the evening, money for breakfast, money crisp. This guy's like Mr. Krabs. Alright, where am I gonna find the remaining one? Where's the other one at? Oh, did I take the elevator before? Hold on. I'm gonna go upstairs. All right. I thought tonight's stream would be a little bit shorter, but look at this. It's wild, huh? Thank you. Oh, what is this? Why are they glowing? How long is this elevator ride? Help! Oh, I should be here. What the hell? I didn't go anywhere. Hold on. We're gonna go down then. We didn't go anywhere. We just listened to the music. Okay, so it's basically doesn't take you anywhere. Never mind. Didn't we already
Stepping
get...
into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Crushed by the weight of this revelation, Stanley may have broken down into an emotional dumpster fire if not for the soothing presence of the bucket. Even now, in his darkest of hours, did the bucket's warmth and guiding light pierce the dark clouds of confusion and chaos. It would be with him, always. The bucket would. And he knew it.
Okay.
The two
Please
of them were inseparable.
Let this be over.
At this point, Stanley was so absorbed in the tender spiritual connection he shared with the bucket that he didn't notice the keypad behind the boss's desk. Nor in his bliss of simply being near the bucket did he have any notion that the pin number for the keypad was 2845. But Stanley guessed the correct code by sheer luck. Was it the bucket knew all along? Was the bucket guiding him? Yes, this is certainly the most logical explanation.
Alright, there should be only one, two or three more remaining, I think. Oh man. By the way, chat, what do you guys think of the game so far? Like, is it something that...
Stanley and the
that
bucket
walked
straight
seen?
Ahead through the
Isn't
large
pretty
door
wild?
That read, Mind Control Facility.
Okay, so this time around we're not gonna turn it off. We're gonna turn it on.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley and the bucket both wondered to themselves.
Cute, interesting, definitely not boring. I never saw the bucket endings. I think this is the part where they added the DLC, right?
And Stanley nearly dropped the bucket in shock. Everyone in the office was being videotaped, monitored like guinea pigs. The bucket had never seen anything like this, and
oh,
it
no,
very
bucket.
Nearly
it's okay,
burst
bucket.
Into tears.
Don't cry, bucket. Look at this.
Reassuring it that everything would be fine.
It's okay, it's okay. It's okay, Bucky. We'll be okay. And I have no idea what's going on. Oh, it's a we're going on a journey with me and my best friend slash partner Bucky. Alright, go.
Was the bucket under the mind control facility's influence as well? Had the
we
bucket
need a
been
Bucky
told
emote,
to do
right,
things
Chad?
It didn't
think?
Wish to do? What kinds of things does a bucket want
as
to
Faith
do
suggested?
Or not want to do in the first place? These questions raced furiously in Stanley's feeble mind.
Let's go.
No! He screamed into the bucket. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control, never!
Matrix. Yeah, I've seen Matrix. I haven't seen the latest one. The number four,
His one friend
right?
in the entire world. At this point, he could trust no one except for the bucket. But here was the proof. The heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions. Happy, or sad, or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place.
Uh-huh.
And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in,
the last
Stanley
one,
decided
I heard
that this machinery
about it, mostly
would
bad.
Never again exert its terrible...
Turn
but
on.
At the last second, the bucket jumped in and pressed the button to turn on the controls.
Bucky, what,
Stanley
what have you done?
Gasped in horror. Had this been the bucket's plan all along? To take over the machine and claim the power for itself?
Bucky, how could you?
The bucket have betrayed him like this.
How could
Stanley
you, Bucky?
Stanley was prepared to throw the bucket away in disgust when suddenly
an image appeared on the enormous screen. Oh?
Birds. Silly. Silly birds.
Wait, he
the
took
control.
The control
buttons became active again. Stanley flipped through one video of silly birds after another, and then it dawned on him. This wasn't a mind control facility at all.
Uh-huh.
It was a facility for monitoring and surveilling silly birds all
oh,
over the world.
Okay.
The mind controls were only a facade to disguise its true intentions.
That's crazy.
Had the Bucket
what?
Known this all along? Stanley marveled at the metal genius in his hands, the one who had pointed him towards this incredible discovery.
Right.
Stanley and the Bucket never found freedom because they spent the rest of their lives here in this place, flipping through live streams of the silliest birds imaginable.
That's not a bad
way. Of all the possible paths his life could have taken, this one was surely the best.
The best.
And Stanley was happy.
This was actually one of the good endings in terms of the Bucket endings. Wow, okay.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
There's only... Ooh, what
Stanley
is this?
Decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
One more remaining on that ending. When we go to the office, we gotta escape.
The test of time.
Then we're gonna find
Stanley
that ending. And then there's
the
one over here left as
chest,
well, I think.
And entered the door on his left.
At this point, we're gonna do like 100% of the game. Almost. Alright, so we need to find the remaining piece of the figurine, right?
Coming to a staircase, Stanley and the Bucket walked upstairs to the boss's office.
Oh! No! Business strategy. Killing pandas? Oh my god. 2845 is the code, I believe.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. But Stanley guessed the correct code by sheer luck. Was it that the Bucket knew all along? Was the Bucket guiding him? Yes, this is certainly the most logical explanation.
Here we go. The other ending.
Stanley and the Bucket walked straight ahead through the large door that read, Mind Control
Facility.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley and the Bucket would both meet a violent death.
If I go back, what would happen?
But of course, Stanley and the Bucket thought better of it and realized they simply had too much to live for.
Maybe not. I changed my mind.
It's death for Stanley and the Bucket.
I changed my mind. Here we go. The sweet death.
The door behind them was not shut. Stanley and the Bucket still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
Nope, we're not going to do
that. At this point, Stanley and the Bucket were knowingly walking forward into a very painful death for each of them.
All right, here we go. The ending that we got earlier. Oh. I'm not afraid. I got Bucky with me. We need to collect the other figurine, the
one. As the machine whirred into motion and Stanley and the Bucket inched closer to their demise, Stanley reflected on how meaningless the Bucket's warmth and comfort had turned out to be. To be sure, it puts the mind and the soul at ease to embrace the Bucket, but what use is a sense of ease when you're about to be crushed to death?
Oh no.
This is what Stanley thought to himself.
No, Bucky!
And he sort of kicked himself for wasting so much time carrying a Bucket
Listen,
everywhere.
Listen, Bucky, I know we're about to
Farewell,
get clapped,
Stanley.
But at least we're together. Together forever, Bucky! Oh, the lady was gonna take over.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley and the Bucket were led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, the Bucket's life came to an end as it was crushed violently to death.
Okay. Ooh. Ah, there we go.
It was a shame, the death of such a magnificent Bucket.
I know,
it's
right?
It's true that all Buckets are radiant in their own way.
Wait, what is that?
This one stood above the rest. It was a glorious Bucket to behold.
The Bucket. Welcome to the grand exhibit. You are standing at a Acknowledge Master Bucket of Mankind frequently. Okay, cool, cool, cool. Interesting. Oh, we're gonna get this
ending. Can you see how arrogant it was for Stanley to take a bucket like this and to claim it for his own? Can you see the hubris that blinded him?
Hey, why are you taking
it? Can you see that the bucket is far more noble than Stanley will ever be in his short life?
It's the stress bucket analogy. All right. This whole area, oh nah. We got ancient drawings about buckets too, like they're cave drawing. We do not know by how long. The cave drawings depicts that early man's discovery of the practical issues of the bucket. They're praying to the bucket gods.
No man can own a bucket, and certainly not a bucket as dazzling to behold as this one.
Uh-huh.
It is man who should kneel before the bucket.
The hanging bucket. We got Bucky. Let's go.
But there is something we can do. Uh-huh. Something we can do together, you and I, that will right this terrible wrong. Let Stanley die. Let him be crushed by the machine. Don't reset the game. Don't give him another opportunity to run off with another
beautiful bucket. She wants the bucket for herself.
We can save both buckets from their treatment as tools and implements.
No.
If only we let Stanley
die. Bish. I knew that's what you're planning to do.
As ruler, as leader, as commander of a new world, a new vision.
What is with people trying to steal my bucket, chat? Why my Bucky? Why? I know it's a magnificent bucket. I know it holds more than, you know, transports water better than other buckets. But that simply can't be the reason, right?
Wait, no. This isn't the right office, is it?
Wait, what?
Is this? The bucket made Stanley want to be a better man and a better co-worker.
Co-worker.
In time, perhaps, he would become both of those
things. The end is never the end.
Stanley clutched the bucket
tightly
to his chest.
Okay, so last time we went...
And entered the door on his left.
That way. All right, so we're done. The left door. We got all the endings on the left door. We gotta go do the right one. There's, I think,
this
one
was
left.
Not the correct way to the meeting.
By the way, how you doing, Mike?
But Stanley had felt the bucket calling to him, telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to be.
Uh-huh.
And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct? Well, no. Never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting. And so the two of them detoured through the maintenance section and walked straight ahead to the opposite
door. Do we go down? Chad, do we go down already or no? Oh, what's this? Locked. Go down? I think... Do we go down? I don't remember. Oh, nah. Now we got... What do I do? Can I restart? Quit to menu and then come back. There we go. Okay.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting. Not everyone is so lucky to have a bucket, but Stanley is a
I should have finished the right side first
very
and then head to the
indeed.
Left. Because Stanley, I didn't think there would
the
be actually each,
this was not
like different endings for each
room,
single one.
But Stanley had felt the bucket calling to him, telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to be. And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct?
It's
well, no,
a crazy
never
game.
Mind.
I don't think
wrong.
I've ever played anything like this. It's
Stanley
wild.
Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room. And so the two of them detoured through the maintenance section and walked straight ahead to the opposite door.
Oh no, I think we did come here. There's a baby. So what part
oh,
did we not
good
find?
Stanley, I'm glad you found your way here. I knew you'd find this place
eventually.
Yep,
I knew. This we already saw.
You see, your friends and I are concerned for you, Stanley.
So which way did I not go?
Because we care about you very much. It's this bucket you're carrying around everywhere. The bucket isn't even from the original
so which
Stanley
way I
parable. It's just
where
sequel
could the other...
content. We're the ones that matter, Stanley. Classic characters from the first game, like the Adventure Line and the Broom Closet. Because that's what fans want from a sequel. They want more of their favorite jokes, not
I'm
this
wondering,
bucket
like, what else,
that they've never seen
where
before.
Where else we have to go?
Yes, I know I'm the one who gave you the bucket, but you're spending too much time with it.
Don't you want another story involving the Adventure Line? We could make the Adventure Line go somewhere new. Yes, yes, that's what the fans want. Let's do it.
All right, maybe there's another alternate option.
Who knows where it'll go off to next?
We'll
see. And it played some silly music as well.
Drops and then it's gonna suddenly stop.
Now this is what the Stanley Parable is all about. Don't you remember all those great jokes from the original dialogue?
Also, Stanley is addicted to drugs and hookers.
Yes, it's as classic now as it was back then. Let's do it for the fans, Stanley. Let's give them more content exactly like this.
Take it back to the escape pod.
But if we want to do that, you're going to have to give something up.
Was there an escape pod?
Don't you get it, Stanley? We need to get rid of the bucket. That's why I'm very proud to introduce a brand new character.
Oh, we could get the bucket ending after destroying the... Okay.
This is the Bucket Destroyer.
Okay, so this is another ending. Gotcha, gotcha, gotcha.
I think it'll make a wonderful new addition to the rich lore of the Stanley Parable.
Bucky, listen.
It also was not in the original game, but it's such a well-fleshed
out character.
You will be back
soon, okay?
With so much personality that to me, it already feels as though it's been part of the cast all along. Don't you agree?
I'll bring you back. I'll find a way to bring you back. I'll use the Dragon Balls, okay?
Surely you don't need me to spell it out for you.
I will use the Dragon Balls to wish you back.
Go ahead now, Stanley. Say goodbye to the bucket, and then pop it into the machine when you're ready.
All right. See you in a minute, Bucky.
Now listen to me. It's crucial that you give it the bucket.
Wait, I can't.
I don't know what the Bucket Destroyer will do if it can't destroy your bucket. Destroying buckets is all it knows.
I can't push it
in. That is its singular personality trait. Sure, I can hear you saying, how does a character with only one personality trait deserve to join the pantheon of beloved Stanley Parable characters? Well, you see, if you were to really explore the Bucket Destroyer, you would see that its desire to crush buckets is so densely loaded with complexity and nuance that it's really like 10 personality traits. What other object in this game can you even say that about? The broom closet? Certainly not. I wonder what sort of Bucket Destroyer merchandise the fans will be clamoring for after this. Okay, the Bucket Destroyer is getting very upset now. You'll have to hurry and feed it. We can't get back to the classic Stanley Parable characters like the Adventure Line or the Bucket Destroyer until you crush that damn bucket. Quickly now, the fans are waiting. Do it, the fans, Stanley. Give the fans what they want.
I physically can't. I've been pressing the button. He wouldn't throw it in. Okay, so, Mike. Let's see, did you take the boss's office but not go in and take back to the escape pod? So, you're talking about the boss's room where you have to enter the code and then you gotta do something else, is that what it is?
We were going to do such marvelous things with you, tell such spellbinding stories about you. All of it squandered now. Goodbye, new friend. For the moment in time that you were here, you were magnificent.
We just need to find one more. Oh, man. What is the other place that we haven't checked?
What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Okay, so before you go into the double doors to the boss up, pretend to go in, then leave quickly before the door closes and go back.
It takes a lot of humility to carry a bucket so magnificent. Stanley checked his ego and then proceeded onward. Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door on his left.
Okay. So the double doors is the one. Wait a second, what? I could open other doors?
Do you feel it? The broom closet. It wants the bucket. You can feel that, can't you? The aura of jealousy? It's as clear as day. This broom closet believes it deserves the bucket. I can really feel it now.
Uh-huh.
It coming to a staircase, Stanley and the bucket walked upstairs to the boss's office.
We've already checked that down there before. All right, here we go, boss's office. Alright, so double door, you mean this door, right? So before it goes in, we're just gonna go in and get out? Okay, stop. What do we do? Go in and go out.
Stepping in.
Oh, okay. Oh, now it's locked. All right, cool. Now what do we do? That's wild. Okay, the bathroom. Now go back down the office. Ain't no way. How would anybody figure this out? Like all the way down? Or do we go back? Okay, let's go back to the office. What is all this? Warehouse access plan. Trust the completionist instinct. Oh, the door next to your office. Oh, okay. All right, here we go. Is that locked? Yeah, that's locked. Like, how is anybody supposed to figure this out? Unless anybody tells them, right? Oh! Oh, okay! Let's head in. You are now leaving. Escape pod bay, floor 760. Oh, nah! This is crazy, what? Don't trust that. We gotta try it. Because this is a new ending that I haven't seen. How long is this damn staircase? Take it all the way up. 755. 60. Oh nah, we actually have to like walk. How big, how tall is the building again? I don't remember. All right. Oh well. Hopefully not too tall. Go ahead. Mike, thanks so much for 200 bits. Really appreciate it, man. Thank you. Appreciate it. 7. Okay, we're getting close. Escape pod launch bay. Ain't no way. Wait, what? I can't see. Oh, there we go. Alright, you guys ready? We're about to make history. Let's go! Bucky, it's you and me forever. Oh, whoa, what are you doing? Dude is like, yeah, Bucky, yes. What? Go, wait, why is he not going in? Nah, don't do it. That's Clark Kent, Superman, and Goku. Oh no. What did I do, chat? Well, I guess that was it, huh? Wait, so where would I find the remaining
Someone was following Stanley. He was sure of it. If he checked over his shoulder now, he would surely catch them. It was only a matter of time.
Someone is following them? Wait, what? What does that mean? The bucket's not there anymore. Bucky, I miss you. I miss you, Bucky. Oh, chat, the bucket's gone permanently. Oh, no. No more Bucky. What happened? No more bucket. Oh, no.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Now what? He said somebody's following me. What does that mean? We need to find the last last one.
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track.
The other... Wait, what?
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
There's no way, right? So without the bucket, can I find the... I think we can still find it, but... You know what? I'm gonna take the escape pod myself this time. I wanna see what happens.
Stepping in.
There we go. I wanna do it myself, Chad. There you go. Oh, that's what you're supposed to do? Alright, here we go. It's done. Are we gonna see ourselves? Imagine. Turn the damn PC off. Save the electricity. Oh, the door is open now. Alright, here we go. We're gonna do this again. Oh. You're now leaving. Okay, so we don't have bucket, so we're gonna follow the bucket this time. Let's see where that leads us. This game is so crazy, like, how did they even come up with all these insane ideas? It's like they probably had, someone had a fever dream and then they're like, oh shit, we could actually make it into a full-fledged game. And here we go. I'm playing the Ultra Deluxe, yeah. It starts again. Alright, let's see what happens. This time I don't have buckets, so I guess I'm gonna be heading in there myself. Just for the sake of it. I guess we'll do it. Alright, here we go. The escape pod. Keep going. There we go. There we go. I live in Philippines. Gotcha. Welcome in. Oh. What happened? Hello? It went dark. You can never escape, can you?
All of his co-workers were gone.
Guys, I think...
What could it mean?
There's Stanley nothing else. I unfortunately couldn't room. Find
Perhaps
the last
Perhaps he had simply
piece.
Missed a memo.
I don't know where to find the last piece. I really wanted to. We got 5 out of 6. I don't know where the last one would be. Like, the one thing I can think of is... The Stanley Parable. Lost your mind yet? Oh, I'm losing it. Oh! Bucky!
And try not to lose this one too, you dolt.
What? Excuse- Oh. Wait. Wait, the layout changed. Wait, the layout changed. 5 out of 6 what? The collectibles. The layout changed. This might be it.
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to his chest and entered the door on
going
his
right.
Left. This was not the correct way to the
Bucky's
meeting.
Alive.
But Stanley had felt the bucket calling to him, telling him that the employee lounge was simply the place to
I
be.
I thought the bucket was gone forever, but I guess not.
And here it was. Had the bucket turned out to be correct? Was no, never mind. The bucket was wrong. Stanley took the door on his left to go back to the meeting room.
We've already been there before. I'm gonna go this way.
No, said the bucket. Don't go to the meeting room. Go somewhere else. The cargo lift, yes. Go there. Go to the cargo lift.
You guys see there's a path right there, up there? Wait. Okay, waiting. There was one down there we got, but I don't know if I follow over there, if there's gonna be something else at the end. I don't know. Take it down there, this way? We've already went there before. And almost at the end of that, we found the collectible. I'm just looking for the final one. But it could be realistically anywhere, so I don't know. Should I go? I mean, aside from that, like, we've already went down there before. I went up there too. And there's a car at the bottom. Or a truck. You know what? Did you do the ending when you turn off mind control? I did. We did all that. There should be one more, but I just can't. Yeah, with the bucket I did. Yep. I'm trying not to come back to this game. Like, I'm actually trying to finish it tonight so we don't have to come back. Okay, if I go in.
Oh, well, look who's got cold feet. Well, from here, it looks like the only way forward is down, since the lift won't be coming back. But that's okay. You've got a bucket. Did you know that buckets are routinely used as cushioning devices? It's true.
Wait, what?
You can fall on a bucket from literally any height and survive.
No way, really? Hey, should we try, chat? Should we try?
I'm serious, Stanley. Jump. Jump with the bucket. I promise you'll live. I extra double promise
yes.
That you can land on the bucket and not
no,
die.
I did you know first and then did the yes. Alright, here we go.
Whoops. Looks like I was wrong. How clumsy of me.
Wow. What? This guy literally had me killed.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it
okay,
mean?
He's like, oops.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps Stanley cradled the bucket in a gentle embrace.
Did you take it out of the window? Wee.
Assertive.
Out of the window? How do you do it again? He's jealous of your love for Bucky. Mm-hmm. That's for sure.
Stanley clutched the bucket tightly to
okay,
his
so
chest.
If we go left, we're going to end up going in the meeting room. And then from the meeting room, we're going to have two options, the staircase upstairs or downstairs. If we go down, we already got the ending. Wait, how? Okay, hold on. If we go down through the, down the staircase, not up, down, how many endings in the down? I feel like there might be more than one, or was it only one? What am I missing here? I feel like we're missing one at least. Trying to see if you go to the meeting room, you have an ending. Yeah, you have multiple endings in the meeting room from there, because you could either go to the mind control room turned on off and then escape, or we could go down. Jules, have a good night, catch you later. Oh yeah, it's already late, shit. You know what, I'm gonna go this way. I'm gonna go down the staircase again. If we don't find it, it is what it is. Okay, I'm gonna look it up, see what happens if you find all six. Maybe a video on YouTube. That's all we gotta do. I'm actually done. Hop down.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley and the bucket walked upstairs to the boss's office.
Okay, here's we found one. Oh no, this is where the looping starts. That's where the looping starts. It doesn't help. It's not gonna help. There's six endings for the left door, seven for the right door, and five for both doors. How do you do both doors, by the way? Oh! Okay, I know what to do. Here we go. I know what to do. I'm just gonna do the same thing that I did.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley
before
decided to go
doors?
To the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Grab the bucket, take it out the window, the first office area.
Ah, Stanley's bucket. The only co-worker he would ever
the window?
Need.
Like
Stanley
right here?
Stanley clung the bucket to his cheek. Could his co-workers really all be gone?
No, I did not go out the window. No. That window? How do I get out, though? It doesn't let me. You were just at it. It says meeting today. Climb on top of the desk to the... Gotcha. 434. Oh, this? How do you climb this? The desk 434. Okay, gotcha. Wait, how do you climb? Oh! What?
Yes, whispered the bucket into Stanley's ear. We've done it. We've escaped from that dull office and that pesky narrator. At last, out here in the white void, we are alone.
How am I supposed to figure this out?
The bucket began to tell Stanley of its life and its history, of the countless wars it witnessed, desecrating the land and lives of untold numbers of innocent humans, and the bucket's own complicity therein, of sadness and regret. And the many years it spent dwelling on the actions it might have taken to curb the madness and the decay, if only it had been stronger. Of hope and redemption, and its crusade to uplift the stock of life for the common man, to manifest justice where none existed, and the bittersweet reality of time, to see one's dreams and wishes met halfway, meted out in parcels like charity, and abandoned as soon as the warm glow of inspiration begins to dim. The opportunities to do so much more. There was so much it could have done, perhaps, the bucket wondered to itself. Perhaps, if it had seen its own darkness with a clearer perception.
And a few
this was way too much for Stanley.
What are you talking about?
He screamed.
You're a bucket!
To this, the bucket furrowed its brow.
No,
said the bucket.
No.
Not since the evil wizard Gamb-Horata first ensnared me in his machinations as payback for the sacred amulet I stole from his treasured vaults. I was young back then and could not conceive the ramifications of...
No!
Stanley screamed even louder this time.
This is stupid! You are a bucket! This is so stupid! Why are we even doing this?
As Stanley screamed and screamed and screamed, the bucket revealed its true form, transforming into a mighty beast of untold power, its fangs glistening like...
What?
My God, Stanley, you did it. You saved us from the bucket. Thank God you already had all 12 emblems of sages and knew the incantations to summon their true power. Otherwise, we would have easily been overwhelmed by the bucket's power. I'm speechless.
Oh, you've demonstrated such bravery. I'm so sorry. Your juices went to waste.
Let's restart the game, and we'll agree to never again go trifling with this bucket, nor the dark magic cast away inside of it.
Well, all right. You know what, chat? I think we got all the endings now. However, we still haven't found another collectible. But I want to see what happens if you find all the collectibles. I'm going to look up the video real quick, okay? It's going to take 2 minutes and then that's it. Alright, here we go. This is the final thing that we got to watch because we haven't found this. And because of that, we haven't had the 100% of the game. Have you taken the bucket into Bucket Haven? Bucket Heaven? Wait, what? How do you do that? That's crazy.
It's just... it's those figurines. Yes, I know we're supposed to be telling a story, but won't you please indulge me with one more trip back to the memory zone?
What?
I would love nothing more than to revisit the figurines. Yes, I
Wait,
know.
Wait, what?
I last one. Wasn't it...
Oh, last one. Okay, after finding that, you're gonna go over here. Oh, it's the same place. Okay.
The first collectible. Back then, we had no idea of how many of them we'd find. Sure, it said 6 right there on the screen, but how could we know for certain? Stan Loreen, you found this one all on your own just by poking around behind the boss's office. You
there's 8 out of 6.
Stanley. I'll be honest. Back then, I had no sorts of...
Is this a joke?
Exactly right. It was here whom you found your third mini stand. Can you remember? That's exactly right. It was here in the warehouse.
Ain't no way.
It was the third one. You picked it up, and then after that, you had three of them. I'm glad these moments are so crystal clear in your memory, but I shouldn't be surprised. After
you know
all,
what? It's fine. This game is crazy. If you wanted to do 100%, you'd go crazy.
Third time doing anything.
Okay, just skip.
Too clearly. To commemorate the occasion. Enjoy.
Oh, it just gives you the locations, right?
A lot of time making that video, but it was 8 minutes I wouldn't have spent on anything else.
That was part of the game? Wait, what? The monitors that you click throughout the game every time you get an ending. Every time. Oh, I did not know that. This game probably has the most ending I've ever seen in any video games.
The final figurine.
More than 20 endings, right?
Speaking of. Then there was no more.
Okay.
Because we've caught up to the present moment. Nothing left to do but move onward into the future. Goodbye, Memory Zone. No, I'm not done. I'm not ready to move on. Stop the loading screen. Isn't there some way we can stay here, keep enjoying these figurines? Let's just go backwards. We'll do the Memory Zone again from the opposite direction. See how that feels.
This guy's crazy. Faith, have a good night. The stream tonight was supposed to be shorter, but instead it just...
Still down room? These really were a treat to hunt down. You know, if there had been any kind of reward for finding all of these, it really would have Newton. Yes, I... Okay.
Okay, so basically you're going in reverse, right?
Memory, this one.
16. Can you believe we couldn't find 6? There's 16
now. Everything else, there was your office.
Uh-huh.
Something I feel I can remember.
And it starts a new day, I guess.
Yes, I'm remembering something now. I remember before this whole story got started. Back then I was different. I used to make big decisions. I was passionate. I was skeptical. I weighed each decision with profound thoughtfulness. And then
18 out of 6.
I stopped making decisions. I became lazy.
By the way, welcome in, Vampire Blue. How are you doing today?
I came up with a character named Stanley to do my thinking.
It's crazy.
He would make the decisions. He would decide which way to go. I would cheer him on as he collected figurines for no reason. Why did I invent Stanley? Was I lonely?
Probably.
Yes, perhaps that's it. Perhaps I needed to imagine I had companionship. And Stanley really did make for a wonderful companion, even if he was a fiction. But I suppose it's grown old. I want to think for myself again. I want to go back to how it used to be. Yes, I can be on my own again. I can do it. I'll be stronger this time. I'll take care of myself.
You're still alive, Justin.
I don't need
jumped
Stanley
in,
anymore.
For a few. Oh, yeah, I was supposed to end the stream in like 10, but
you know what?
I thought I'd be able to finish the game, but it just took.
How about one more good memory? Let's
but from now on, the streams would be ending at 10.
Stanley one more
because I have less time to do anything else. It's too much.
Good.
What do you think of the game? Incredible. So incredible. Like it's 10 out of 10.
Okay. Here we go.
It's completely different.
This is the story of a man named Stanley.
Than all the other games I've played so far.